Hi, I'm Pat from VMOD 3D Library. Today, we're going to explore the process of applying textures from the VMOD texture library in CLO 3D. First, let's take a look at the final render. You can achieve a photorealistic look like this by applying VMOD's textures and tweaking key parameters. Let's get started. Today, we'll be using this texture. FYI, this item is now available for purchase using the free trial credits on our VMOD 3D library website. If you're having a hard time spending hours rendering realistic fabrics in CLO, we have a solution for you. VMOD's ZFab files are professionally created and ready to render, giving you fast and beautiful results. You can simply download the ZFab file and see the magic happen. But if you only have PBR maps, let me guide you through the process of how to render realistic fabrics and show you exactly what to do. I'll download a high-resolution texture of 663 ppi. Shall we take a look at the texture list? I just downloaded the necessary textures for rendering. Although you can see 7 types of PBR maps and mask maps, today we're going to solely focus on utilizing PBR maps. We'll cover the mask maps in another video, so stay tuned. For today's tutorial, we'll be using 5 out of 7 PBR maps. Base, Normal, Displacement, Roughness, and Alpha map. We are not using the Metallic and Ambient Occlusion map, because this is a non-metallic fabric and CLO 3D does not support the Ambient Occlusion map. Here we have imported an object with a nice drape for rendering purposes. Let's apply textures to this fabric. First, let's apply the base map. It doesn't look right in the 3D view. This is what happens when applying PNG files in CLO 3D. But this issue can be easily solved. You can use a tool like Photoshop to convert the base map to JPG format. Click on the open file icon located in the Property Editor window. This is what you'll see in Photoshop. Click on File, Save As, to convert and save it as a JPG file. Or you can press Alt-Ctrl-S. After replacing the base map to JPG and removing the alpha map, you can now see an improved 3D window. Or you can simply enable quality render on the top left corner of the 3D window, without replacing the PNG file. For this video, we'll keep quality render enabled. Now, let's check out how the base map is applied. It seems like the fabric scale is too small to see the details. I'd like to make it bigger to make the details more visible. However, if I increase the size now, I'll need to adjust the scaling of the normal, displacement, roughness, and alpha maps to match the base map. So, I'll later adjust the scale after applying all the maps. Click on the open file icon of each map and import the downloaded map. Like I mentioned before, I'll import the rest of the maps except for the metallic map and ambient occlusion map. Now, let's move on to adjusting the scale. We're going to use Edit Texture to adjust the scale of the texture. Press T to use Edit Texture and adjust the scale to fit the object or garment. Simply right-click while dragging the arrow and enter the desired value in percentage for precise adjustments. Let's raise it to 400% to make the details more visible. Now you can clearly see the characteristics and details of the fabric. I think it looks great. You can also adjust the scale from the transformation section of the property editor. Please be aware that you should adjust the scale after applying all the textures. It's because updating a map during the scaling process will reset the applied scaling. Now it's time to tweak the detailed parameters of the maps you've applied. To ensure its accuracy, I'll start by showing only the render view, as what you see in the 3D window may be slightly different from the final render. From the top bar, click on Render in the Render section, and then select the 2D button located at the bottom right to see the full-sized 2D screen. After that, click the Render button at the bottom, and only the render window will be visible. Now, let's click on the Interactive Render from the top right corner. Let's look at the render screen to find the appropriate parameter values for each map. Okay, let's now briefly touch base about today's render scene. To create a lighting setup similar to three-point lighting, I used both HDRI lights and rectangle lights. The rest of the render settings are configured with simple presets to minimize the overall rendering time. Before we begin, I purposely set the normal intensity to 0 to only show the base map. First, let's begin by creating realistic depth by using the displacement amount value, and then we'll adjust the normal intensity to add contour. I'll change the displacement amount value to 1.34. Now it looks more detailed and realistic. By reducing the particle distance, you can also achieve more details. But we won't use this today because we're adjusting the normal intensity. Now let's move on to the normal intensity. Considering how well the displacement is applied, a minor adjustment to the normal intensity would make it even more realistic. Let's put it to 20. This is actually a matter of your creative preference. If you want to make it softer, you should lower the value. But if you want to make it more detailed and intricate, I suggest raising the value. If your device specifications are insufficient for rendering, or if the final render takes too long, you may consider removing the displacement map and utilizing only the normal map to illustrate the details. Moving on to next, the roughness map. The roughness map accurately reflects the level of roughness found in real-life fabrics. Though you don't have to make extensive adjustments to the value, you can achieve various appearances based on your creative preference. It may differ slightly from the actual fabric, but I'll add a touch of glossiness here. I intensified the brightness of the reflection by adjusting the roughness map intensity and reflection intensity. If you want this to be less reflective, you can decrease the value of the reflection intensity to 10 or lower. I'm pretty satisfied with how it looks right now, so I'll start rendering. Last but not least, the opacity map. Opacity map does not offer detailed parameters for adjustment. You can only adjust the overall transparency. This opacity map doesn't need any further modification, but if you have something specific in mind, you can modify by using software such as Photoshop or Substance Designer. This is how you apply PBR maps in CLO. Please keep in mind that the parameter values provided may differ based on fabric characteristics, personal creative preferences, and device specifications. Lastly, the object used for rendering and the project file containing the lighting setup can be downloaded from the VMOD 3D library tutorial page. Please check the Show More section for more details. Today, we learned about how to apply maps and adjust the details in CLO 3D. I hope this tutorial has been helpful to you. Once again, using ZFAB files created by VMOD's experts, you can effortlessly render stunning and lifelike fabrics without any hassle. If you have any questions, please leave comments below. Our team will be more than happy to answer. We're going to make more videos about how to use digital fabrics in various 3D software programs, so stay tuned. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe our channel. See you next time.